Hello, everyone. Happy Friday. We made it. It's almost a weekend. Except for the time zones where it's already the weekend. So, to those people, happy Saturday. I think it's technically Saturday in, like, Australia. I'm not too sure about, like, the far-flung time zones. Okay. This area resembles a boss room, but it's not. It's the Lucky Sandwich room. Another Mr. Saturn coin to sell. No, I threw away or used all of my protein drinks. I'm sorry. Oh, I was just on the other side of you. Sorry. I haven't been diligent enough about my key items. Is this a mini boss? What just happened? I think that's supposed to be a boss, like a mini boss. But it's different in the randomizer. Hi, Apple Kid. Oh, I think if I give him food, he just gives me the receiver phone, which is just an item that'll take up space in my inventory. Not too excited about it. Experimental Visitor. That's a new class of UFO. Let's laser. Let's fire. Let's freeze. The experimental visitor has a lot of hit points. Oh my god. How many hit points does this thing have? Like a billion? A trillion? It's probably a trillion. Bottle of water. Nice experience. All right. That's that. Oh my god. So many monsters. One monster. I'll fight one monster. Hey, it's you. Okay, magic is overkill on that thing. Another broken trumpet. I don't think there's anything else I can do with those. Mario didn't seem interested in fixing the second broken trumpet. And I don't think it would sell for much if he did. Oh, okay. So that's the shortcut back to... Oh, right. Okay. Well, if I have a shortcut there... Then I can go to Magnet Hill and set this as... The the mark location for my exit mouse. And I have a quick and easy shortcut back to Threed now. Or back to Magna Hill from Threed. Mark. Good job, Mark. Wait, was this a pencil or an eraser? I might be able to get through here now. Yeah, very large iron eraser. So if I use the eraser, the iron eraser statue disappears. And what the heck is over here? Oh. It's a Robobot. This is another part of level 6. Because it's what is love again. Alright. A Robobot shouldn't be too much of a threat at this point. It was 50% weak. I don't remember. I'm sure whatever it was, I'm misremembering. It's been too long. Okay. Yeah, not that much of a threat anymore. Thank goodness. Right, that's the pencil statue. And I still don't have the pencil eraser. Maniacal lover. A. I don't think I like you, maniacal lover. Decent experience. Crappy level. Alright, heal Mario's poison. And I think talking to this person... No, talking to the frog is a full heal. This person is just, I don't know what their deal is. I think there's bugs. I don't think there's anything else interesting to the north. Ow. Look at that defense discrepancy. Oh boy. How do you feel about fire? I'm gonna have question mark heal themselves, just in case they get attacked again. Cool background. Oh, ketchup packet. I have a speed capsule. I'd like to give it to Monty. Well, I'd like Monty to have more speed, but I don't think I'm going to achieve it through speed capsules, so I'm going to give it to question mark. Because I want question mark to continue having the chance to go first. And yeah, my instinct was right, there's nothing up there. Had to double check. Okay, a light. What are you? Whatever you are, alright. There's just one of you. That's a lot of damage. I didn't think poison did that much. Oh my god. Question mark continues to evolve into the ultimate beef lord. Alright, patch up my Mario. People having a bad time in both restrooms. All right, that's a monster trash can. Oh, so many options. So many options, so little time. Out of my way, vegetation. Liquidated model. Question mark, is that what you are? Are you one of these molecular models? Fire? Or ice? Ice is good. Beating them up is also good. I don't like this background. Too busy for the eyes. Decent level for Ness. Real treasure? Silver bracelet. Sorry, buddy. Silver is yesterday's news. Carcinogenic spark. I still haven't found even one Tesla badge that can reflect a lightning attack. That is troublesome to me. I think I'm back in Mole Country. Oh, okay. So I circle back around here, which isn't surprising because there's like six potential exits out of here. Oh no, it's protected from all the psionics I'm going to use. That's not good. Ow. Get out of here with your weird sound effects. Alright, decent level for Monty. Not such a great level for Mario. I think I have access to this treasure chest, and I think there might be a mole and another treasure chest further north. defense ribbon. Not as good as the shiny coin. Hello, mole. What do you know? Yeah, this one's the third strongest mole. Unlike the other one I fought, which was the third strongest mole. This needs some healing. Hopefully I can destroy the same before it's a problem. Good deal. Ness, heal thyself. Oh, now I get the pencil eraser. Crikey. Need to sell some of this junk from Ness's inventory. Monty, give that... excuse me, to question mark. Well, if I'm going to get the hiccups, at least it's at the end of the recording session. Or close to the end. Run from this fight. Now I kind of want to go back the way I came. For now. Nope. Really easy to accidentally double back on the exits. Defend. Because there's no rhyme or reason to how one exit connects to another. So I could be walking north, go through an exit, come out an exit, walking south, and since I'm still pressing north, I'll just immediately double back where I was. Ah, finally, we reached the other part of this room. That's a treasure box that I got way back in, like, episode Mumble Mumble. That's kind of a big area. Actually, I think it's just, it's a big area, but I think there's only a couple exits here. There's like the Stonehenge exit, and then I think there's a cave up north. Might as well check it out. Oh! Excellent. Well, that takes me back to Tucson. So I have another convenient shortcut back to a sanctuary if I need one. Another shakedown. I can't afford $3 per person. $12 is too expensive for me. This couch isn't an ATM, is it? No. I didn't think it was. Look, if you're not going to accept debit cards, then you should have an ATM I can use. That's just courteous. The scorpions are worth kind of a lot. Okay, well, that was an interesting diversion. Actually, that shortcut doesn't help me a whole lot, because this whole section of the dungeon is kind of out of the way in terms of the general path I want to be going. I don't want to go that way. I want to go this way. I want to get back to Threed. This is a boss room. There's a boss at the top of that rope. Whirling something. Okay, I'd like to see what this thing is vulnerable to. I don't think it's vulnerable to freeze, but I'm going to try because what else is question mark going to do? I think this thing has some nasty attacks. Okay. Freeze is somewhat useful. Okay. Yeah, that's a scary, a frightening late game enemy in regular Earthbound. Is this taxi afraid of me? No. The taxi charged right at me. Oh, I should have used that shortcut in Tucson and gone back to the sanctuary because question mark is running a little low on magic. Shop? Horn of life. That's good. Are you an ATM? No, you're a telephone. Of course, it's a hotel. That's how hotels work. Well, that's another part of Threed. Diamond Band. I have no idea how much money I have in the bank right now. Yeah, much like Johnny B. Good, this is sort of a mashup of What Is Love with a song from actual Earthbound. I don't like these things. They have a lot of hit points. Luckily, I have a lot of damage. Pretty sure there's a boss at the top. I don't know what I hit there. Okay, so these things are like the worthless objects and stuff. Eventually their magic will start working. But it takes a while. Now, the worst thing about this fight is its background. Thousand experience. No, no boss. Okay, I take it back. Is this an arms dealer? No. This is another hospital. The arms dealer is the shopkeeper who you can buy bottle rockets from. If it's a late game arms dealer, you can buy multi-bottle rockets, which is the single most damage dealing thing in the game. Once you are done buying equipment and stuff, the rest of your money typically goes to multi-bottle rockets. Okay, you're afraid of me, so get out of my way instead of blocking the dang exit. Thank you. Alright, let's go back to exploring Threed. Deluxe fry pan. Nope, not as good as the French fry pan. Is that a French fry pan as in a fry pan from France? Or is it a pan for making French fries in? The world may never know. Coin of slumber. That might actually be better than the shiny coin. Wait. Who got that? Monty. Oh, it's other. No, it's not. I can never keep track of which coin is better than what other coin. Treasure room. IQ capsule. Rabbit's foot. So, unlike regular Earthbound, question mark does not learn Starstorm from a story event. You find an item in the chest that allows question mark to learn it. So use auto star master. Yeah, question mark realized the power of Starstorm Alpha. And then there will be another one at some point, which gives me Starstorm like Omega or whatever. There are two power levels for Starstorm. It costs a lot of magic points, but it does a lot of damage. The rabbit's foot is good. I'm glad I found that. I don't know if I'm going to use it right away. It is a slight defense loss, and I... Yeah, actually, let's do that. So that increases Monty's speed to 56, making her by far the fastest party member. So, with Monty able to go first, then I can spy right away, or I can cast Psy Shield right away. The other thing I might want to do with the rabbit's foot is give it to question mark. Actually, does that... I'm not sure if that works that way or not. Let me check. Like, it might drop question mark speed to zero. I know it drops the defense to zero. How does it affect their speed? 75. So that would guarantee question mark goes first, at which point I would be able to cast like Shield Epsilon Shield Sigma on the first turn. But if Monty's wearing it, then Monty would probably be able to cast Psy Shield on the first turn. And I do have Sigma. Yeah, arguably it's more important to be able to cast Psy Shield than regular Shield. So, and I don't really want to drop question marks defense like that just yet. So I'm going to give the rabbit's foot... No. That is not what I meant to do. I'm going to give the rabbit's foot to Monty. Monty is going to equip the rabbit's foot. And then Monty will give the rabbit's foot to... Ness, I think. Here, Mario, have a mammoth burger. So yeah, Monty will give the flame pendant to Ness. Ness will equip the flame pendant instead of the crystal charm, which also gives a nice defense boost. There we go. It'll probably be a little while before I have to worry that much about enemies using Psy right away, but it's good for Monty to be fast. Like, this was a very good treasure room. I found Starstorm for question mark. I found the Rabbit's Foot, and I found an IQ capsule, which I don't really know who I want to give that to. In regular Earthbound, I usually give it to Mario or Jeff, because a higher IQ means he's more, he can repair more items, but in the randomizer, repairing items isn't as big of a deal. It's not as important of a mechanic, but for tradition's sake, I will go on ahead and give it to Mario. Okay, well, I think this is an excellent place to end it. I still have a lot of Threed to explore. I feel a lot more confident than I did for pretty much any of these other videos. I haven't made that much progress, but I did. I haven't made that much dungeon progress. I've made a lot of progress as far as like powering up my characters, giving them good equipment, getting them spells, leveling up, etc. So I'm feeling a lot better for the future of the randomizer. I hope you all have a good weekend, and I will see you on Monday. Goodbye.